To manage 1.3 billion people, 28 states, 8 union territories, 700 plus districts, and multiple governance challenges, India relies on three pillars of democracy: the legislature for creating laws, the judiciary to interpret laws, settle disputes and administer justice, and finally, the executive, which holds responsibility for governance. This arm executes and enforces laws. District administration is part of the executive, and this is what we'll be explaining in this video. Let's start with the most elementary question. What is district administration? To understand this, we have to first understand the hierarchy of the executive branch. There's the central government, the state government, and then the local government. The central and state government have the prime minister and the chief minister as their respective heads, supported by a council of ministers, who in turn lead their own ministries or departments. Now remember this point, this is important. At the local level though, the executive has two parts, urban and rural. The urban areas are governed by an urban local body, which is headed by a mayor. Rural areas consist of gram panchayats headed by a sarpanch or gram pradhan. Okay, but what is district administration though? Most commonly, the district administration covers a geography consisting of some urban areas and some rural areas. This holds true across all 739 districts of India. District administration is not a level of government. It is the execution branch of the state government and supervises local governments, both urban and rural. Which brings us to the next question. What is the structure of the district administration? The district administration is structured to deliver the mandates of the state execution branch. Remember the departments and ministries headed by ministers? You have definitely heard of some of them. Education, health, agriculture, to name some. To understand this better, let's take the example of the education department of a state. There is a district education officer, several block education officers, and numerous village education officers, who in essence are teachers. Now apply this hierarchy to all departments. Across departments, numerous village level officers report to few block level officers, who in turn report to one district level officer. Similarly, in terms of upward reporting, the district level officer of each department reports to an officer called the district collector or DC, also known as the district magistrate or deputy commissioner in different states. Thus, there might be 25 to 50 district level officers reporting to a DC, and she is the one who leads the district administration and is the state executive's implementer in chief within a district. The job of being a DC is one which is invariably given to a new joinee to the Indian Administrative Services. A DC typically spends 4 to 5 years in a district. How many such implementers in chief do states have? There is no fixed number. Haryana, with its 22 districts, has 22 DCs who report to the state executive. Uttar Pradesh has 75, while Himachal Pradesh has 12. And finally, what is the role of the district administration? At the macro level, the DC is the implementer-in-chief or the chief coordinating officer of the district. She has to be aware of the work being done and the progress being made by officials across all departments, remove bottlenecks, and streamline coordination between departments that might need to work together. Mm-hmm. Here's what a typical day for a DC looks like with its multiple competing priorities. Reading and approving budget proposals for development projects, chairing review meetings with district and block officials, presenting the district status in reviews by state executive, undertaking field visits to schools, hospitals, Anganwadis, hearing out grievances of district residents. Is that all? No, here's a list. Given the expanse of responsibilities that rest with the DC, it is not surprising that much of her time in this role remains being reactive to the mandates of the state government of firefighting when unexpected events occur, with little time to be creative in designing solutions to governance problems. So what have we learned today? We have learned that the district administration in India has multiple complex and competing responsibilities, affecting lakhs of citizens. But with great power comes responsibility, and with great responsibility, even greater respect, and that too from the world's greatest client, the citizen. And this is what we mean by district administration.